The Sunbirds still searching for that first win in conference, taking on second-place Chaminade. And even shorthanded, FPU came to play 1 minute into the game, and Jackson Carbajal gets the easy lay-in down low to take a 4-2 lead. He finished the game with 16 points, one of three Sunbirds in double figures. Then Malcolm Griffin getting in on the action with the floater down the lane. On the ensuing possession, Griffin picks Lee Bailey's pocket and goes the other way for the monster jam. But it wasn't all in the scoring column tonight for Griffin, as he lays off the dish to Josh Mason for the lay-in and then finds Carbajal on the alley-oop. Then one more time on the slip screen by Drew Packard. Griffin finished the night with 20 points and 9 assists. Second half, Sunbirds keeping pace with a pair of nice threes by the freshman Philip Randles. And in transition, Trevon Clayton goes down for the layup to give the Sunbirds a 1-point lead. He would finish the night with 19, but it wasn't enough down the stretch as the Silver Swords take this one 83-78.
Our guys battled hard. I mean, I think we tied the game 7 or 8 times in the second half, but, you know, again, couldn't get over the hump. You know, I thought took some ill-advised shots at some bad times and were a little careless with the basketball and, you know, didn't take care of the glass. I mean, you get out-rebounded 14 times. It's hard to beat, you know, good teams. And, you know, I was proud of the fact that our guys did battle, but, you know, it's disappointing again to come up, you know, to come up short at home.
I think we penetrated well, got the ball moving. But one thing we didn't do well was rebounding, and I think ultimately that's what lost us the game.
Well, we knew that if we made them guard for the whole shot clock that we could get anything we wanted. So, you know, we just tried to move the ball and not take quick shots. You know, they playing to their game. They want to play up and down like that. So, you know, we just tried to keep the game how we wanted to play, you know, at our own pace and, you know, make them guard. So that's how we got easy shots today.
All we can do is try to have a good practice and come out and play hard with who suits up. We can't control who plays and who not. So, I mean, the 7 or 8 or 6 or whoever plays, we just have to play hard.
Since we only got 8 players, we got to just play. It's no room for error. You know, we just got to play almost perfect game, you know, to get some wins with only 8 players. Even if everybody's healthy, we only going to have 9. So, you know, it's just tough, but we got to adjust to it. You know, nobody's going to lay down for us and let us just walk over and win. We got to go in and take every game.
You know, we got to get back to work. We'll be off tomorrow, get back to work on Wednesday, have a great practice on Wednesday. Hopefully we'll actually have, you know, 8 or 9 guys so we can practice. That would be very nice. But, yeah, I mean, we just got to, you know, stay with what we're doing, continue to play together. You know, and each guy, including, you know, every member of our coaching staff, we got to look at ourselves and continue to see the areas in which, you know, we can improve.